What is NDFA?
Okay, NDFA. NDFA, till now we have covered deterministic finite state machine, that's it, DFSMs. In shorter version is called finite automata, FA. And NDFA is nothing but a finite state machine where from one state to one state you can jump with the same symbol. So it is a basically very confused thing. It cannot be realizable hardware, but it sometimes helps the computer scientist from capturing the regular expression to NDFA, because there is a fixed algorithm that there how to convert NDFA to DFA. I have covered, already given note, I'll again cover from NDFA to DFA, the number of states are generally more, either equal or more, but that is realizable hardware. Okay, NDFA are two types, one without epsilon transition. Epsilon transition more harder to design. Epsilon transition means it can, from one step to one step, it can go jump without any external simulation. So NDFA is, but the power is same as a DFA. But what is the use of NDFA? NDFA's use is to capture the regular expression. Regular expressions I have already covered. Regular expression and regular set are basically same thing. Regular set is a notation, you use a set symbol like second bracket opening, second bracket big end, union operation by U cup, and regular expression U is replaced by plus sign. So that's it. Have I answered your question, Devajyoti? Devajyoti, you have to go for read the books, the good books, and Peter Lee's book you please follow, you for Michael Sifsat book, it little bit tough, but it is very good book. Kohobi's book is finite state machine, but not any particular book where all the things are there, it is not that. Exception is Peter Lee's book as per our coverage, but unfortunately I couldn't manage the Peter Lynch book soft copy. If you can manage, you can please send me. Okay, but Michael Sipser's book is available, Kohobi's book is available, and my PPTs are available, my doc file also available to view today itself.
Sir, last day I asked that in type 2 grammar, in Chomsky hierarchy of type 2 language, what is the significance? Is gamma is belongs to the union of the terminal set of union of terminals and non-terminals?
Yes, this question I think is Ahobika is again trying her level best. Yesterday I've also tried, but I think still she has confusion. I'm first try to tell that gamma is nothing here. Okay, forget about gamma. What is gamma? There is no place gamma here. First thing is, in some books they have different symbols. So your sentence to be accepted or not, it may be from type 3 language or type 2 language, type 1 language, type 0 language. What is sentence? The sentence is nothing but a concatenations of terminals only, no variable. So gamma cannot be there. So sometimes a variables we declare it by capital A, capital B, or sometimes big gamma. Big gamma is a variable sometimes in some books. Please, this in a sentence there is no such place variable up there. Then how the intermediate variable come? Because for the production rules, whenever you generate sentence, you always start from S symbol. You remember the grammar, how the grammar is there. Grammar is fourth tuple. There the S is the start symbol, P is the production rules. Okay, so that is the, from as per the nature of the production rules, we say whether it is a type 3 grammar, whether it is a type 2 grammar, type 1 grammar. Whether the production rules left hand side, if we say only one variable, then it might be type 3 and type 2. Either, because for type 3 grammar, left hand side only one variable, and right hand side a single terminal or a series of terminal, at the end a variable, that is right linear grammar, or at the beginning on only one variable or in many terminals, that is a left linear grammar. That's great. But you cannot have both the rules. If both the rules, then it is a type 2 grammar. Type 2 grammar, the left hand side is always a only single variable. So in both the cases, in type 3 grammar, in type 2 grammar, the left hand side variable is always a singular person. Okay, so then the next grammar, type 1 grammar, that is called, then we call context sensitive. Why context sensitive? Because your left hand side variable has some, anything can come, any other variable, any other terminal. So that is the reason called context sensitive. That is a type 2 grammar. And the example sentences, a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n. And then come the type, this is a type 1, this is type 0. What is type 0? Any formula of mathematics, b square minus 4ac root over divided by 2a, it can be represented by this type 1. Okay, like this, any algorithm. So that is the powerful thing of the Turing machine and all these things. And there are you can have any, left hand side can be any string, right hand side can be any string. Okay, so that's great. I'll come at the length of the string, I'll come, there's some restriction on the length of the string. In the type 3 grammar, in type 2 grammar, in type 1 grammar, the left hand side length of the left hand side string, like this mod. So what is the mod of type 3? It is always left hand side 1. Okay, type 2 grammar, the length is always be 1. And in the context sensitive grammar, it is variable, it may be 1, it may be but in type 3 grammar, in type 2 grammar, in type 1 grammar, mod of left cannot be less than mod of right. So your right hand cannot diminish. But if there are some rules are there, s can goes to epsilon, say start variable goes to epsilon, then what is the mod of epsilon right hand side? 0. And what is mod of s? 1. So 1 less than 0. So only that rule is allowed in type 3 grammar, type 2 grammar, type 1 grammar. But all other rules, the mod of right hand side always greater than, it cannot diminish, except one rule, s2, only the start variable can go to epsilon or lambda, in certain books is a lambda. Okay, but in type 0 grammar, length of the left hand side can diminish. So that is the reason we, the powerful things. So whenever you see in our poetry or English language, we do not say the full words, full sentences, we give half sentence, but it has a meaning. So that is type 0, very difficult to understand. So all programming languages are basically type 2 grammar, that is context free grammar. I have repeated once more, I've told you, you can see the IIT Chennai madam's video. Her book is also available in the Miss Kamala, I think, Professor Kamala Krithivasan. Yeah, her book is also very good in the library. Whenever you next time, you can order it through Amazon. That's very good book. Peter Lin's book is also good book, and Kamala Krithivasan book is only iBook recommend in Indian scenario, not like Mishra's books. If are any of you are following Mishra's books, I do not like Mishra's books. Anyway, so what I am calling, in Kamala Krithivasan has told in the lecture, you please see the NPTEL lectures of Kamala Krithivasan, Formal Language and Automata Theory. She mentioned that all English language is basically context free language, more nearer, but our Bengali or Tamil, we are context sensitive language, our grammar, because every grammar, every written language, even spoken language, you have to have follow a grammar. Say subject, term, verb, cross for second. This is English. English is very strict. So that is why English is very favorite language for programming. So see, there are many languages, Spanish, French, they are more popular all over the world. But see, English is favorite programming language. You see the Python, that is almost like English language. So why I'm coming back to Ahomika's question. So there should not be gamma, because gamma is not a terminal symbol in any book. So terminal symbols are, most of the books are covered 0, 1, and that is alphabet is sigma, is a set of 0, 1 or a comma b, c. Okay, this is smaller case. So all sentences should be generated from the production rules, and the sentence should not contain a gamma. And whether the sentence is accepted that machine, then we call the machine the sentence is accepted and it is a part of the language. So whenever you call a regular language, that means regular language will be like a to the power m, b to the power n, not m and n, no relation, or a to the power m, b, a, b to the power n, this kind of grammar, or like a to the power m, b to the power n, a to the power p, no relation between m, n and p. These are basically finite state machine. You can just capture a m times, b p times, c q times, no relation m and q. But if there any relation, like whether a to the power n and b to the power has to be same, then you need a stack. You put a into the stack, and when the b comes, you pop a and take it out. So it matches at the end of the your stack finishes. So these are the context free language, and for that is the reason our programming language are nothing but a deterministic context free language. What is deterministic context free language? Like a to the power n, b to the power n. What is non-deterministic context free language? Take a palindrome, like whenever Adam has met Eve, he didn't madam, I am Adam. If the sentence is there, you can read from left hand side madam, I am Adam, and from the right hand side madam, I am Adam. That is a palindrome. Palindrome, there are lots of examples out there, the palindrome, like which reads from left hand side and right hand side. Like in Bengali, one palindrome is there, Ramakanta Kamar. If you see the Ramakanta Kamar in reverse, that is also a Ramakanta Kamar. So that is interesting language characteristics, but that palindrome detection cannot be done by deterministic PDA. You need a more powerful non-deterministic PDA. But unlike finite state machine, where we have will prove and we have already told that deterministic FSM and non-deterministic FSM are same power, no extra benefit, only catching regular expression to get it, but you have to convert. But for palindrome detection, you need a non-deterministic PDA, because you simulate that every time the midpoint comes, you instead of popping, you take pushing. Instead of pushing, you take the popping. So it can't have any random time. At one machine, palindrome is detected. Like that is a non-determinism example. Remember the Sifsas note. Okay. So Ahamika, am I sense or anybody? Is it okay? Whatever I have told, no gamma picture is here. And that is a Noam Chomsky. That is a famous computer scientist, linguist, and political commentator. She is still alive. He has single-handedly developed this language concept. He proved that most of the 99.9 languages are there. There must be some grammar, and the grammar are mostly same. But some grammars are complicated, like in Tamil and Bengali, and most simpler is the English. Okay, so that's it. Omika, is it clear? Yesterday question. Please again tell yesterday question once more. Anything you have not understood? Please.
Yes, sir. Clear.
Clear? Doubt?
Clear, sir.
Achha, yes. Anyone has any doubt? Anyone has any doubt? Oh, there's a good number of people. 55. Sir. Yeah. Devajyoti?
Please tell the others theorem.
See, this I have not covered. Those who I have covered, I will cover it in my class. Okay? Do not worry about it.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. Others theorem, I will cover it. I will cover it. And whatever I have already done, please try to make a question on it. Anunna, any question? Anyone, please? Ognivo, Akash, Omri, Tahona, Archana, Urijit, Arnob. Anybody doesn't have any question? You should have asked question. It is always better, otherwise any doubt you have, like Arden's theorem is very simple example. I'll cover it definitely, so that you can detect that is allowable. P plus Q P thing. I unless and until covered, I'll need not give a question on it. Anyone, are you listening or not? I wish question. Omika, can you make another question? Any question you are welcome. These classes is only for question answer session, and if you cannot ask, that is a negative, because of all my lectures I am already given. Yeah, can you mic? There is no chat section. Nirankar, please read books. I have already covered. Okay, DFA with state diagram. Okay, I will cover all these things. Okay, let's then go for today's topic. I will try to cover this.
Sir.
Yes. What's your name? What's your name, please?
Ritam.
Yeah, Ritam. Tell me.
So today you just gave the video lecture 12, Mealy and Moore machine.
Yeah.
There you have said it like the Moore machine is more stable. So I didn't get that. Like how can you please explain that?
Yeah. Yes. Definitely. These are two kinds of FSM. Okay. The why Moore machine is stable? Because both machine is giving output. Okay. Whatever the traditional FSM we have covered till now, there is no output. So this is output is a different concept altogether. In whatever finite state machine we have done, then whether it comes to a accepting state, we say we raise green flag, yes, accepted. If we are not in a accepting state, we red flag, not rejected. That is the output. Okay. Now this is a separate kind of output that gives with every input input symbol. Remember, this output is different. Okay, but there are very useful things like our counter machine. So that is the thing. But if you put a counter, if any clock signal comes, say take the example of your digital watch with your LCD displays, and if your LCD flips every few your hour flips very fast, so it might be a Mealy machine. So it is better to Moore machine, because Moore machine takes output only when from the state is a stable thing, and Mealy machine gives output with the transition. You remember this transition comes from any edge detector flip flop or any spurious signal in electric. Okay, you are working in an environment where the digital interference is much more. There are lots of Wi-Fi signals and lots of electric motors, your pump and huge motor, and there are some you are not intended, but the spurious signal come, and Mealy machine will give output, and that output is not maybe your designed. So that is the reason. But Moore machine gives output whenever it reaches a state. Remember, in our earlier FSM with a state, we don't have any output. We say at the end whether we have accept, green flag, whether we have reject, we say red flag. Green is green or red, that accept or reject. This is a typical decision problems in all automata this theory. This is one. Mealy machine and Moore machine, even our next machine, like push down automata, they are also no output intermediate. In Turing machine, no output intermediate. All they are giving at the end of the string. But Mealy machine and Moore machine is a one kind of machine which gives output at every transition. So that is the reason we choose the Moore machine. The Moore machine might have more number of states, and from Mealy machine you can convert Moore machine, will show the step. Very simple. Like if we say here, S1 to with a 0, it goes to S2 and output is 1. So I will consider is S2 1. So I have a new state, our Moore machine, it will be S with 1 output. Likely with output we have all state with 1 output and a 0 output, so number of states will be more in Moore machine, but it will be more stable. Your output will be available after reaching state. We will show it. At least bit clear to you? Difference between Mealy machine and Moore machine? Any?
So I have a question.
Yes, what's your name, please?
So it's Ritika here.
Yeah, great. Ritika, tell me. Ritika Mandal.
And what?
Ritika
No, sir. Ritika Rao.
Ritika?
Rao.
Okay, Ritika Rao.
Yes, sir. And what if, sir, if we try to convert Moore machine into Mealy machine? And I actually, my point is about the conversion.
Yeah, yeah. First, you basically try to understand this thing. And conversion, if better, whenever you go for Mealy machine to Moore machine, that is much more easier to understand. And if you understand that, then from Moore machine to Mealy machine, we can understand. So first we try to understand Mealy machine to Moore machine. The what you get that, see here, this is a Mealy machine. How can you detect whether the machine is Mealy or Moore? Whenever you see the here right output something here, forward slash, that is output. It is output from the output alphabet. Okay, that is a Mealy machine. So whenever we are jumping from S1 to S2, so in Moore machine, whenever you convert, we'll make three more states. So here, say here S1 with output 0, S1 with output 1, S2 with output 0, S2 with output 1. This is S0 output 0, S0 output 1. So instead of three states, then we have six states, and then we redraw those arc with no output because we are going to state. So this is a conversion from, I'll show you. What is the algorithm? Algorithm is whenever you are making a transition to another state, you make a transition like here. I am making S, like here S2, I am going to S1. So this state will be, new state will be S1, because output is 0, it will be S1 0. This is a new state, not this state. So I will label this, draw another diagram where and what is it will be S1 0. Same way, whenever from this is S1 from 0 to S, this is S2 0, and like this. Okay, so this I'll cover it. Okay, I'll more detail I'll try to cover. So your class test, your this MCQs, we only have a definition of Mealy and Moore. Conversion will be another test very soon. Okay.
So Arden's theorem is not in the syllabus right now?
Right now it is not there. From my class test, from my this thing here, until and unless I cover in the class, there will be no questions set up in my class. Okay? But you can always read and ask the question. I will try to make two more videos in Arden's theorem and conversion of Moore to Mealy, Mealy to Moore. If it I can produce it, and if I give it 2 hours, 3 hours, 6 hours time, then it will be in the syllabus. Okay, so hope so I'll be able to do. I'll give 2-3 hours period to so view that. You are smart people, you are very smart, you can quickly learn. Okay, and I'll also side by side PPT doc file I'll give, but you can always, good question that you are asking this question, I'm happy. Any other question? Yeah.
No, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Any other question from others? There are 60 students. Only 2-3 people have question. Are you all there or not there? Okay. Great. So, any question? Any doubt?
Yeah. So, DFA determining mediation.
Yes. Who? What's your name? First, you tell your name because I have in a full presentation mode. I cannot see you. Yeah. What's your name?
Sir Devajyoti Das.
Devajyoti Das. Devajyoti Das, your question.
Sir, DFA determination.
DFA?
Determination.
There is no such topic, DFA determination. What is DFA? DFA is a kind of automata. For with every input symbol, it go to one and only state. And that is DFA. Determination, I am not getting the point. What is your question, please, once more? What your question, please? DFA determination. There's I have not found. You just anybody can help with him in the question. Anybody can understood. Devajyoti.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the words. Can you rephrase your question in another language? Yes. Okay. See here, this is DFA. Say, and this is NFA. So, what is NFA? With a symbol, it can go any state, more than one state, and it is also epsilon transition is there from this state to this. So, this is basic difference with DFA and NFA. That's it. Okay. Any more question you can raise at any point of time. Please, whenever you ask the question, you just say. Any doubt from anywhere, please.
Yeah. So I have a doubt.
Yeah,
sir.
Yeah. What's your name, please? Yeah, Ritika, you have good question.
Sir,
tell me. What's your name?
Yes, sir. How to?
What's
sir,
your name?
Ritika.
Ritika, full name?
What? Sir, Ritika Rao.
Ritika Rao. Yes, your second question, probably. Yes, Ritika.
Yes, sir. So, how to determine whether, sir, two automata, suppose two state is given. So, how to determine that which one is equivalent? Actually, how to identify the equivalency if two state is given?
Yeah, now, I got your question, but you have probably take it differently. See, there can be two finite state machines are given to you. If the finite state machines number of states are same, they must be, and they, if they accept the same language, what is the language? String. They must be the same one and only FSM. So, but in case they accept the same language, one has a three states, one has a four states. So that means these four state FSM can be reduced to three state FSM. Whenever the number of states are same for FSM, they identify, accept one and only regular language. Is it clear? But that is only true for type 3 language. That cannot be said for about our context free language. So if there's a one is grammar portion. So for any regular language, you can have one and only one grammar. But for a context-free language, like a to the power n, b to the power n, like balanced parentheses, like there, from the two grammar, they accept the same language, but you cannot say, then if they accept the same language, we can call this equivalent. But they looks different. You cannot convert. But fortunately, in regular language, in finite state machine, if a finite state machine accepts a language, same language is accepted by another finite state machine, if they have number of states are same, then the two FSM are equivalent. But if we have a FSM with say three states accepts the same language, another FSM with the five states accept the same language, technically it's equivalent, but it is not. That machine can be converted, reduced to this machine. Ritika, any sense to you? Have you got this thing? This is a good question. So anyone can raise a question right now. Yes, Ritika, got my point?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt? No doubt. Please look into it. I'll ask next day the question about you. Okay. Like right now, I ask the question. But please ask the question. Ahamika, what is the gamma in your sentence? Ahamika, are you listening to me? Ahamika, are you listening to me? What is gamma? Yeah, what is gamma?
Sir, gamma gamma is basically a symbol that is used in the language it's a set of terminals and non-terminals, and it is defined to define some production rules.
Okay, I think you are following that book, our Indian author's book. Which book are you following? Please, Ahamika.
Sir, yeah. I followed all the books, Michael Sepser or Mishra, whatever I think.
Don't follow Mishra. Yeah, I got. Please, let me complete. Yes, you are correct. This is Mishra's books, the gamma is there. So, please, no other books, the gamma is there. Please don't follow Mishra's books, okay? Please follow Michael Sepser, Kohobi, any other books. Anything can be anything here, but in most of the 90% of the automata, the sigma is the use as a alphabet, set of alphabets, okay? And gamma, big gamma, is also set of alphabets. We will use it in push down automata. Generally in finite state machine, I never seen good books we are using gamma. Might be used, but everywhere you see the sigma is a capital sigma, is a set of alphabets. The alphabets generally 0, 1 or A comma B comma C or A comma B. This is the two most work. And another is, I have told you regarding the variables, and Sepser use the non-terminals, both are same. Some of the books use V in concept, whenever they are giving a fourth tuple, the V is the set of variables, and same is NT, non-terminals. T is the set of terminals, S is the start variable, capital S is always the start variable. That's it. And gamma is used, we'll use gamma in our push down automata as a set of stack alphabets. See, everywhere the alphabets are changing. They might be same, but they are not same. Like here in finite state machine, Mealy machine and Moore machine, we have input alphabet 0 and 1, and our output alphabets, unfortunately, have shown 0 and 1, but I can have AB or something like that. But that is a different alphabet, say O here, and here the sigma here, and whenever A to the power N and B to the power N, to understand the language, when I am getting A, I push to a stack, I push A, but that A is a different, that is, whenever I push some character into a stack, we call stack alphabet. Okay, stack alphabet, one extra symbol, that is in some of the books it is written Z0, capital Z0 is the end of stack marker, most of the books. And the input, Sepser's book, say B hash is the character, like our C new line, it is the end of input. You see the Sepser's book, your all terminals are coming in a square box, in a paper strip, square box, and if ends with B hash, that means it reaches the input of your string. And now you have to say whether I accept it or not. So there are some conventions in most of the automata good books. Please follow this convention. Gamma is mainly used, is alphabet, stack alphabets, not in here. Okay. Good question, good doubt. Any question, doubt, I think today's time is over, your next class